Today, I just wanted to share a few things I have been working on lately. So this is using the real-time API to actually try to build an agent that we can use on our computer and how this could change how we operate computers in the future. So we are using function calling with the real-time API. So this means that we can create a bunch of functions that can do actions on our computer just by using our voice. So you can see some of the functions I have created here. So we have open up the browser, navigate the browser, scroll up, scroll down. We have added an open notepad function that can write notes to our notepad. Take an analyze screenshot. So we take a screenshot, send it to GPT-4o for analysis to get like the content back. Write on screen, so we can use voice to write, copy text, paste text. And these are all the functions I have done so far. So I just wanted to make this video like a preview of what's to come. So let me just show you how this works now. So if we fire up this now. Good morning, Ava. Could you go to YouTube, please?
Good morning, Chris. Sure, I can help with that. Going to YouTube.
Okay, that's great. I also need to go to Hacker News.
Let's head over to hackernews.com. Going there now.
Yeah, great. I might have to copy some text here on Hacker News. Could you help me with that? I'll let you know when I've highlighted some text here.
Of course, Chris. Just let me know when you've highlighted the text you want to copy, and I'll assist you with the rest.
Okay, I highlighted some text. Use the copy text function, please.
I've already copied the text you highlighted. Is there anything else you'd like?
Okay, that's great. Now open up a notepad, please. Paste the text. Okay, that's good. Could you just summarize this into like one sentence, the text you just pasted, please?
Certainly. The text describes a new Hugging Face repo featuring Meltemy 7b Instruct v1.5, a Greek large language model, and introduces Lamafile, a format by Mozilla Ocho that packages an entire...
Okay, so I had to cut that short because it was very annoying. But you can see here, we did a function call, right? Open up YouTube.com. We did a second function call, hackernews.com. And this is the way it works. So we basically call the functions we have in our code just by using the voice, right? And it's pretty cool. And you can add a bunch of different functions here. So this is just going to be a preview of what I have tested out so far. So the next part of the video is just going to be me sitting in my chair and just testing out this. I tried a few different things. Found it pretty interesting, but there's a lot more to explore here. So yeah, hope you enjoyed it. Hope this gives you some inspiration. I would love to hear if you have any cool things you think I should add here. So yeah, like I said, a lot to explore. Hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, we speak soon. I wanted to do a bit of Python learning. Could you go to YouTube for me? Just give me one suggestion for a YouTube channel that has good videos on learning Python.
A great YouTube channel for learning Python is Corey Schaffer. He has a wide range of tutorials on Python programming, from beginner to advanced topics. Check out his channel for some quality Python content.
Yeah, so I'm looking at his channel now. Could you screenshot this? Could you write the code from the video into a notepad? Could you copy it? Paste? Okay, that was pretty cool, but could we actually do this without using the sort function? Could we do it like without using like a shortcut?
Sure, you can sort a list manually without using the sort function. Here's a simple way to do it using a bubble sort algorithm.
Write the bubble sort to the notepad. Paste it. Now you can kind of explain the differences here.
Sure. In Python, the .sort method, or the sorted function, is a built-in way to sort lists. They are highly optimized and implemented in C, making them much faster than most manual sorting algorithms. They also offer additional functionality, such as specifying a custom key for sorting. On the other hand, the bubble sort algorithm is a simple, manually implemented sorting technique. It repeatedly steps through the list, compares adjacent elements, and swaps them if they are in the wrong order.
Could you go to hackernews.com, please?
I believe you meant to https://hackernews.com.
Yeah, I was reading like a blog post here. It says John Cormack. Could you tell me, like, on a very high level who he is?
John Cormack is a renowned programmer and video game developer. He's best known for his work in developing groundbreaking 3D graphics in video games, particularly as the co-founder of id Software. Cormack played a key role in the creation of popular games like Doom, Quake, and Wolfenstein 3.
Use the screenshot function. So I just wanted you to explain this figure here for me, how reasoning works, but just do it very high level and speak very fast.
Sure. The figure illustrates reasoning in AI models over three conversation turns. One, the model receives an input, green box, processes it using internal reasoning, gray box, and produces an output, blue box. Two, another input is given, prompting further reasoning and output generation. Three, a third input leads to reasoning and output, but with a truncated output, red box, indicating a shortened response. The diagram shows how reasoning helps AI models process inputs and generate outputs in a structured way.
Okay, thanks. That was pretty good. I like that one.
You're welcome. I'm glad you found it helpful. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask.
I have highlighted some text on the screen. Could you copy it? From this code here, what is a good next test we could write?
Given the code snippet, a good next test could be to verify that the generate code function returns a string of the correct length.
Write that text to my notepad. Paste. In the text you copied, there's an error message for my code. How can I fix this? Just give me a short answer.
The error occurs because the random module is not imported. To fix this, add import random at...
Okay, I see. Let me fix that. It says I don't have the string defined.
To fix the error that string is not defined, you need to import the string module. Add import string at the top of your script, along with the import random line.
Okay, yeah, that worked. Now it works. Now I generate a random string here. Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. I'm glad it's working now. Hello, how can I help you today?
Let's start by opening up YouTube.com.
Sure, let's open up YouTube. Please give me a moment.
Take a screenshot of this. So in this video I'm watching, there's this blue or purple and orange crab here. Do you know what kind of crab this is?
Based on the description of a crab with a vibrant purple claw and an orange body, it could be a Halloween crab, also known as a Gecarcinus quadratus. These crabs are known for their distinct and striking coloration, commonly found in Central America.
Yeah, I think it does. But just to confirm this, let's do open up a Google search, google.com, with the name of the crab in the URL query. It says here that the Halloween crab is also known as blackback land crab. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. The Halloween crab, scientifically known as Gecarcinus quadratus, is also referred to as the blackback land crab due to the dark coloration on its carapace. It is known for its striking coloration, resembling the colors of Halloween.
In the same video, I can see this guy. He has these plastic bottles that is kind of filled up with some water inside. I think it's salt water. It's out in the sand here. Do you know why he does this?
In survival situations, using plastic bottles filled with salt water and placing them in the sand might be an attempt to create a solar still. This is a method to desalinate salt water, turning it into drinkable fresh water. Here's how it generally works. 100%, a hole is dug in the sand, and a container is placed in the center to collect fresh water. 200%, salt water is added around the container, not inside it. Alternatively, damp sand can be used.
I found this video here from Lex Friedman. Do you know if he has a homepage?
Yes, Lex Friedman has a homepage. You can find it at lexfriedman.com.
Go to that webpage. Scroll down. Up.
Perfect. Is there anything else you'd like to do on this webpage?
Go to lexfriedman.com/podcast. I can see he has a podcast here with cursor. Could you do a search on google.com with the search query cursor AI? Okay, go to cursor.com. Scroll down a bit. Up again. Go to cursor.com/features. I selected all the text here. Could you copy this? Tell me on kind of high level, what is the cursor features?
Cursor offers features to help you build software faster. Powerful autocomplete. Cursor predicts your next edits, suggesting code changes across multiple lines based on your recent modifications. Multi-line edits and smart rewrites. It suggests multiple edits at once and fixes mistakes in your code. Cursor prediction predicts your next cursor position for smooth code navigation. 7. AI chat, with an AI that understands your code base, helping with questions and bug identification. 6 codebase answers.